So this is super cool. This is my first time ever at Agenda. And Agenda is this giant trade show for streetwear. And everyone's here. Vans, Rebel 8, G-Star Raw, Nike. Literally anyone and everyone that is in streetwear or wants to get into streetwear or the culture of streetwear or the lifestyle of streetwear is here. And we've been trying to come here for like the past 3 or 4 years. And we try to do all kinds of sneaky stuff. I try to get media passes through JK. We try to come here as guests of other people, and it's very expensive. You can either come here as a buyer, like you're a retail store, or you're an exhibitor, and to exhibit is very, very expensive. But this year, we were able to meet someone who got us in, which is really, really cool. Shout out to Paul Gomez, thank you so much. He knows one of the founders of Agenda, so which is why we're here. But we're here to get inspired for Barbell Brigade and to just kind of open our eyes to what exists in the streetwear world. And I'm here with Evan, Ma Bear, Mark, our Barbell team, and I can't wait to show you guys what I get to see. So I'm in the meat of Agenda right now, and one really cool thing about Agenda is because it is a trade show, it's a place where all the vendors come and they want to get retailers to come and buy orders from them. So what you're going to be seeing is what's going to be popping off in probably late 2018, 2019, maybe even 2020. So this is what Champion has going on. Some of these space age looking bubble jackets with patches and stuff. So these things may not look in style right now, but it will be in a year or even 2 years. It's really cool. That's Champion's new stuff. Definitely gonna have to check out the booth behind me. It's New Balance, because I'm rocking New Balances right now. And I've been a big fan of New Balance, I love them. I first got into New Balance as a kid when I used to buy their trail shoes, and then they really entered the whole casual streetwear market, and they're coming out some really, really cool colorways. So a lot of these boots I can't really go in because of the things that they're showing are coming in the upcoming seasons, and they don't wanna get jacked or jocked. So I can only show you guys from a distance, but this is their booth. And these are some of the things that they will be coming out with in the near future.
So I love this jacket right here. This has been like kind of my favorite color these days.
Yeah, what is that, like a peach?
It's like a salmon pink, pinkish, dirty pink, dusty pink, rose.
Yeah.
Rose, yeah, but to make it Barbell, I was saying we should get black, black,
ooh,
black.
I could see that.
Maybe a little bit more fitted, not as boxy as this.
Yeah.
But I could see it being really, really dope.
I like this reflective print too. I could see it come in. They're using a lot of reflective stuff, kind of like us a little bit.
Yeah.
Where like our sleeve right here is reflective.
One little piece,
but they also have
We're working on it.
Yeah, that t-shirt on the floor right there has reflective print. It's really cool to see like all these brands and where they're going, and it gives us a lot of inspiration. It's dope. And it makes me feel good because it lets me know that Barbell's on the right track.
Yeah, so it's really important that we're at this thing right now. This is dope.
Thanks, Paul.
Thank you, Paul.
This is really cool. This is like a skater side of New Balance, where instead of like sneakers, they're more skate and casual inspired. I really like this colorway. That's dope. So cool. So this is super cool. Element Skateboards, they have like this whole like summer camp national park theme launch, and it's like little summer camp badges. There's a little fireplace thing, like fire logs, what are they called? Campfires, little teepees. It's a really cool cohesive look with Native American elements. It takes me back to like my old Boy Scout camping, but with a skate twist and a modern raw edge. I like it. It's fucking sick. What I like about the entire branding of Agenda, it looks really cool and it's really cohesive, from that front big Agenda sign that you guys saw in the first clip, all the way to this chill area where it's just leaves, this little barrel, and these painted palettes. When you look at it, it looks really cool, and there's like this awesome like creative singular voice, and it looks like it costs a lot of money, but then when you really break it down, everything's cheap. Like that is probably a fake tree. You can get probably old barrels for cheap. Pallets are really cheap. Those are just Home Depot lights that they just hung up. So what I really like about like streetwear compared to, I guess, the major labels, like when you look at big labels like LV or Polo, Ralph Lauren, like I'm a big fan of those guys too, but it's a different creative approach. with those guys, we're using the highest quality items. Of course, it's going to be expensive, but with streetwear, they don't necessarily have access to the best fabrics and materials, but they have a lot of creativity put into the garments of clothing, and you can even tell from the trade show that this is also evident here. Look at this dope-ass booth. Everything is VHS. That's so cool. Look at this old-school Jackie Chan movie. Hell yeah.
Yo, Ren and Stimpy.
Damn.
That's
throwback or nah?
Willow, oh my god, I've seen all of these movies.
Rambo 3, you seen Rambo 3?
I have.
I've never even seen Rambo 3.
Jurassic Park. Oh, yeah. I haven't seen Above the Law.
Above the Law. Alright, so I'm in front of one of my biggest inspirations on Instagram. His name's Jeff Staple, and his Staple brand is so fucking cool. He always uses like this big old pigeon coop, and the whole booth is like that. And one thing I really like about his brand is he took the pigeon, and I think I read this article where he was saying that like there's so many brands out there that are always trying to take like the extremes, like a lion or an eagle or whatever. But he's like, but what about an everyday bird, like the pigeon? That represents the everyday person. And people are always looking for like the most extreme shit for inspiration or for like something to look up to. But if you look at a pigeon, it's also very colorful, looks very dope, it's very unique. And if you take something like that, like why can't we use that as a representation of us? And I think that's so cool that he was able to take the pigeon, which is like an everyday bird, but there are a lot of cool colors in it, and make that the logo of the brand. That's sick. So we're outside right now, trying to get a picture with Jeff Staple, but it's appointment only, so we'll see. So Gio just took a picture of Ben Hendrix. He's standing over there, and I'm kind of shy, so I'm not gonna go by him, even though I did talk to him for like 5 minutes already. Paul made an awesome introduction, but I just want to point out that the booth is fucking sick, and it's very exclusive looking. You can't even see what's inside. It's just all black, and it seems like they're going with this new branding with like the lightning bolt inside the flag. And in my opinion, I don't know what's going on behind the brand, but it could be what Barbell ran into, where when we're trying to sponsor events on an international stage, our old skull logo, people found it kind of offensive. And it could be with the way of how sensitive the world is, their bomb logo might, some people might also find that offensive or get triggered by that. So they're finding a more neutral logo, which I think is fucking dope. And I love everything black and white. And I mean, that's what my sweater is. Barbell's like that. And it's really cool to see their booth the same way. Behind me is Pendleton. It's also one of my other favorite brands. You saw that I just bought a bunch of shirts from them. They make all the wool flannels and stuff, the OG wool flannels. And I love all the new Indian print they have coming out. It's really, really cool. Super dope. A lot of these companies, unfortunately, I can't walk up all up in there and show you their upcoming designs for obvious reasons. So I'm gonna have to turn my camera off, but I just love seeing like a culmination of all of my brands. Some not even traditionally streetwear, but they're just coming in and trying to expand the market. It's so awesome. So I'm not too familiar with this brand. I know they make shoes, but the booth is really cool.
It looks like actual concrete.
Yeah. And I like how they had like fiberglass or something and they lit it from the inside. So it looks like it's glowing on concrete. That's sick.
Fuck yeah. I only said that because someone gave me a button that said that. Oh, you can't see it. Eh, never mind. You can't see it. I just sound crazy.
This display is so cool. He's making an actual surfboard in the booth. Look at that. He's sanding it down. Bunch of raw surfboards over here. Really, really cool.
That's pretty badass. I'd be really intimidated to work there, because then if I sneeze and it like identical, fuck, everyone just saw that.
And you put your boogers all over the surfboard?
No. Oh yeah, I didn't see that too.
We got home and Ma Bear already got crazy comfortable. Look at her robe. She's so comfy.
I only like it because when I hug Taika, I like that he smashes his face in here and he's just like, oh, big comfy blanket.
Yeah.
And it's also warm.
But what she's wearing is exactly what I feel, since I'm an introvert. When I go to those events, and yeah, I learn a lot and I meet all these really, really cool people. But afterwards, I felt like I worked for 12 hours. I'm just so tired. Some people are extroverted and they get energy from that and they can't wait to go to the after party. For me, I want to know where the after party is so I can avoid that place. I can go home. But now that we're back, I'm comfy. Took my pants off. So I need to like rinse because I still have another event tonight. Our buddy Ben, who owns Gymshark, he's having a pop-up shop in LA, and we're gonna go stop by that thing. And I'm really excited to see that. And what do you have to say about all of this, you freaking monster? You little monster, what do you have to say about all of this? You big happy guy. You Mr. Happy. You're gonna come back so old when you're like 4. And then you're gonna look at this and be like, wow, I was such a happy baby. Huh. Yeah. Happy baby, Tyka. You're eating the blanket.
It's distracting.
Looks like he's only half enjoying it. Like he's in,
but he's not gonna do it because he sees this big black thing in his face.
Fine.
The camera, you freaking curly haired suit.
There's this new thing that Gio and her mom does where they shake their leg, and I think Tyka likes it, and he likes hearing his voice waver, so every time they start shaking their leg, he actually starts making a noise to go along with it.
Nope.
God damn, are you gonna make me look bad?
You like that WV frog.
Son of a.
You guys probably don't know what that reference is. Yeah, he goes in front of that one guy, and then the guy's like, whoa, and then he shows everyone, he's like, come on, frog, do it. And then the frog's like, ribbit.
I think I was probably like 2. You were probably in college.
That might be true, but you look like you were in college.
Handsome? Yeah, college age is great. That's a prime, 20 years old, thanks. Thanks,
Gio.
That's quite a compliment.
What are you talking about? Thanks for saving that one, baby.